Neighborhood. I'm your host, Jennifer Wakeman. There is an amazing program at the Milton High School where students learn important engineering concepts while building robots out of cardboard. Take a look. William Bean has been teaching high-tech classes at Milton High School for quite some time, but it was a request from his wife that spawned the idea of building robots out of cardboard.
One summer, my wife asked me to make a cardboard whale for Bible school. And so I made the cardboard whale and had a lot of fun with it and really began to look at all that I could do with cardboard.
That cardboard whale gave Bean the idea for an engineering project for his high-tech students. The high-tech classes are independent study courses that allow Milton students to try their hand at everything from multimedia to electronics. There's a great deal of flexibility built into the course, allowing Bean to tailor the program for each student.
I've had students that have wanted to go on into engineering, and we've set up with an agreement with SunCom, where it's a local industry where they provide employment for people with disabilities. And they have needs for fixtures to do some of the jobs that they need to do. And so we've set some of my students up to go down, find out what their problems are, and then they've actually built mechanisms, jigs, and fixtures to help them do their jobs.
Far as Bean knows, there is no other school in the country using cardboard as a medium for building robots. The engineering project is always part of the first 9 weeks of study, and all high-tech 2 and 3 students participate. The program is designed to teach the technological design process.
It basically is defining the problem. They do some research. They brainstorm. They're working in teams. And then they pick from their different ideas what they actually want to build. And then they build a prototype, and we test it.
Much of what the students learn has real-world application, from the research and design to teamwork and testing. Over the last 7 years, the designs have improved. Originally, the robots were tethered, and DC motors ran pulleys that moved the robots. Now, the robots are radio-controlled with sprockets and chains, replacing rubber bands and pulleys. Each year, Mr. Bean designs a challenge that each robot must complete during the field test. This year's task was a soccer challenge. The robots must navigate over a ramp and then shoot balls into a goal at the other end of the field. When we first visited Bean's classroom, on Spirit Day no less, the students were hard at work building and tweaking their robots. The team of Cody Kozer, Kyle Kovalarich, and Tim Conlon had plans to use a scissor lift to help them complete the challenge. However, they had more immediate problems to address, like getting the space large enough to hold the receiver. Meanwhile, Brent Bastian, Sean Zettelmoyer, Joshua Hunt, and Carlos Galvez tested a rotating sweeper designed to shoot the ball at the goal, while also working out how to allow the front of the robot to glide easily. There were a wide variety of robots designed to fulfill the task at hand. A couple of them were already able to tackle the ramp, and we even found one that managed to shoot the ball. I couldn't wait to come back for the field testing a couple of weeks later to see how these robots fared. After the break, we'll take you to the field testing where the robots really strut their stuff.